All right, so as of recording this video, this channel has 94 subscribers. That's not very many, which means that when someone leaves a comment on a video, it feels really significant, and I really appreciate it, because sometimes filming in this studio, it can be hard to remember that there's somebody maybe on the other side of that lens, and sometimes it feels like there isn't anybody. Like, who am I even making these videos for? So when somebody leaves a comment, I just really appreciate it, and it's just really encouraging. And so I thought today maybe I'd reply to a couple of the comments that I've got over the last couple months. Okay, so the first comment is from Chris with three Zs, or Zs, I suppose, because you're probably from the States, but Chris is with three Zs, and this was a comment on our most recent video about cheap lighting. So Chris says, I don't know if you guys have a Dollar Tree up there, but I went there and found these transparent color-coded file folders where each section was separated by a different color of transparent plastic. So basically a book of gels for a dollar. I wouldn't strap it to anything hot, but it could work for a LED light. And that is a great idea. In fact, way better than using tissue paper, because actually these LEDs can get hot. It just tends to be focused light. So if you don't know what Chris is talking about, in the world of film lighting, especially before the days of RGB lights or bicolor lights, you just had tungsten or you had an HMI that was daylight. And so sometimes you wanted to warm that light up or cool it down or totally convert it to the other light temperature. And to do that, you would use gels. This one is like a full conversion from tungsten to daylight. This one does like a quarter. And this one does like a quarter or a third warmer. And when you buy from a big company like that, you get like super accurate color temperatures and all that stuff. But in most cases, a colored piece of plastic will do the trick beautifully. And I would highly recommend doing that instead of using tissue paper 100% of the time. Which reminds me that I actually wanted to show you guys something. We were absolutely shocked with the lighting quality we got out of that cheap light kit we had in our last video. Usually when you see somebody do a cheap lighting kit video, the results are obviously they were trying to make something cheap work. In this case though, they looked so good. So let me just show you real quick what our regular video light setup looks like in this space. So we got a light panel shining through this window, and we've got a Felix 360p shining through this window. We've got another Felix 360 as our kicker, and back here we've got an Aputure 300D mounted with a giant softbox. And all put together, this light setup probably costs somewhere between $4,000 to $5,000 Canadian. Now compare that with that light setup. Not only is that ridiculously cheaper, it is so much smaller. It almost makes us wonder what on earth we're doing with this giant light setup that we usually use when we got those kind of results off of this kit. It just blows my mind that we could hardly tell the difference between this kit and that kit. So I hope you can find some encouragement in that you don't need a ridiculously expensive $5,000 lighting kit to get some really amazing results. But if all we had was this little kit, most people probably wouldn't even know the difference. Camille R says, a great video, my dude. Loving the gift ideas. Keep crushing it. 100% fire emoji. Thank you so much, Camille. That really is encouraging. If you're interested, Camille also has a gift guide with some interesting lower budget, maybe a little bit higher budget than my gift guide, but still affordable items on his channel that you can go check out. And another comment from Chris where he suggests that I should be uploading my videos in 4K instead of 1080p because YouTube supposedly favors that for compression and things like that. So I'm gonna try that. I'm gonna upload this video in 4K even though I'm mastering it on an HD timeline and see if it makes any difference in quality. And Chris, if you're watching this, you can let me know in the comments, or anybody else can let me know in the comments, can you tell the difference between this video and my previous videos in terms of YouTube's compression settings? Or maybe it's a small YouTuber thing and I don't get good compression until I get more subs, right? At the beginning of the video, I mentioned that we are closing in on 100 subscribers for this channel, which is fantastic. I'm so excited about that. I'm so glad that you're here and subscribed. Over the last few years, God has been leading us on such a crazy journey. We have tried so many different things in the world of video and photography, and so many of those things, we felt like they were things we needed to do, though sometimes they were a little bit more pragmatic maybe than they should have been. But through all of that, YouTube has kind of been on the back of my mind. I think it was 2 or 3 years ago, I had just discovered Peter McKinnon and Matty Hipoya for the first time, and Jill and I were like binge watching them and going, wow, those colors, like this is amazing. This content is so interesting and unique from anything we'd ever seen before. And there was something in me that said, I could do that though. It's like my language. I've made videos like that and didn't think they were worth anything, where previously I hadn't seen how the pieces fit together. There was something in my mind that clicked. And I was like, I want to do that. I'm confident I could do that if I would just give it a shot. But I just kind of avoided it. It was just too scary and risky. Perhaps I remember even being on a coaching call at one point with a mentor that we had hired. And he was asking, you know, what is it that you really want to do? If money wasn't an issue, what would you be doing? And what I wanted to say was, I want to try YouTube. But I didn't feel like I was allowed to say that maybe. So over the last year in my dabbling, we've released over 30 videos. And even though 30 videos is a pretty respectable number within a year, the reality is our life was very unfocused. We had way too many things going on, too many things on our plate. So in the new year, we are going to be putting a lot more focus and attention and setting aside time for this channel, to grow this channel, to help you, to help others in their art, in their video, in their photography, to become better filmmakers and photographers and artists, and to grow as people. In the last year, so many people have been so discouraged. The last number of years have been so stressful for so many people. And one of the things I've noticed that has resulted in is a lot of paralysis. People just don't know what to do, and they end up just sitting at home doing nothing. And there is so much that you have to offer to the world. I firmly believe that God has put you in the world where you are because he has something for you to do. The world needs who you were created to be. And as hard as it is sometimes for us as artists, you know, we have a tendency to undervalue our work, to undersell ourselves. You know, the things that come easy to us, sometimes we feel like, oh, like what's that worth? And in a world with political trouble and economic trouble and spiritual and health trouble, it can feel like, how on earth is my art even valuable in that world? But I believe it is. It can be so valuable, and not just abstractly valuable. Like sometimes as artists, we can make up all kinds of mumbo jumbo and blah, blah, blah about why my art is so valuable because I made it and it's original. No, art is objectively valuable, or it can be objectively valuable. And there are people out there who need what you can create, who need the messages that you can deliver. And so that's one of the things that we want to help you with. Whether you're a full-time artist, a full-time videographer, a full-time photographer, or you just do it as a hobby, or in your spare time, or as a gift to friends and family, we need you. The world needs who you were created to be. You are here for a reason and for a purpose. And the giftings and skills that you have learned and been given are powerful when they are focused and used effectively. So I'm hoping that this channel will become the hub for a community of creators, of artists, who together can cut through the noise and change the world for the better. And I would love for you guys to come with me on that journey. If you've got ideas for videos or things that you would like us to make, please post them in the comments down below. Whether you see this video the day it's posted or 3 years after it's posted, post your ideas. What videos do you want us to make? What things do you need to learn? What things do you need to know? Thank you so much for your encouragement and support already to this point. I'm excited to get on this journey with you guys, and I guess I will see you in the next video.